Ongamalai Nada. O man from the lofty mountains, worthless is your promise. In the middle of the night, you come through the bamboo forest, through narrow lanes, unmindful of all challenges, and embraced her. That later left telltale marks and attracted bees. Her mother looked at her with her killer eyes and asked, "Hey, what's happening? Are you continuing with him?" Unable to answer, rattled, she turned to me. I intervened. "Oh no, mother, it was me. By mistake, I had added sandalwood along with the firewood. That's why the bees have come." "She knows nothing, mother. Not her fault." O man from the lofty hills, your promise seems wasteful. Sangam grammar speaks about iraichi, extended meaning of a poem. So here the Sakhi says, "This can't continue for long. I can't help her every time. Don't make a false promise. Please come. Marry her and take her with you."
Okay. I am triggered too much. Sound check. Sound check. Hello, sound check. Okay.
It's a very interesting play. Divya chose the character and she fitted in the character very well. Entire concept of disorientation happened because she was only looking as a hero and talking. It would have been a big blow to Divya. I know how she had taken it so courageously. Shifting the entire point of view was a big challenge.
So you're already establishing she knows what is going to happen.
So again, the direction of the looking and the character changing, the body language, everything was very clear at the end of it. And Divya is naturally very good at expressions. Her beautiful big eyes, I was really awed by her expressions.
Prelude that went drastically wrong. So it was actually pointed out by Mahalakshmi and Divya Kasturi, I think. They went back to the poem and said, "No, the Kutra and the Kelpur are the Sakhi and the hero." Then I said, "Oh my God," I kind of wandered away from the Sangam grammar. That is when I went back to Sir and then clarified it and then came back.
So I thought this song was such an apt poem for you to, you know, bring out all the scoops of your Abhinaya and all your that big eyes that speak.
The change of emotion there from anger to sober. The credit should go to Priyaka for actually taming me. Yeah. I'm not scaring away.
You're also learning how people lived in those Sangam era period, you know. That was quite an interesting journey.
Sangam time is not the time you get to date multiple people and then select the chosen one. You get only one person, you have to stick with that person and you want that person to come back.
You also had a big commentary on the spots. You know, how the spots appear, whether it is, you know, after a mutual relationship or is it just because of thinking about the lust and pining for the love, you know. So those things are quite interesting to actually understand.
The Sakhi is persuading the hero to marry, and at the time she is not being very rude to him. At the same time, she is being very assertive. Audience should not make an effort to understand. So it should naturally be shown like a simple thing.
And I think a huge, huge thing to Manali for, you know, for me, from the morning I've just been singing, "Oh, Manali." It just sticks in my head. I don't know why.
The credit goes to Manali as well.
Absolutely. I just really
like to that song.
when you see her video singing, she's also acting. She's also acting as she's singing.
She also knows the essence of the song, so she's able to bring out that.
The initial plot was an angry Sakhi, you know, ready to face the hero. You know, you better come and marry her was the kind of tone there. So she actually stuck with that and she went all the way up, high, very demanding pitch.
He belonged to that great thing. What do you think you are that great? You know, so it took you on that journey as well. So you say that, no, you're in that great place. What do you think? So it just sort of, you know, all your visual imagery also came with along with it. Because you're telling him, okay, calm down, you know. So yeah, I to me, that musical sort of overlay with your dance, I think was quite stuck, quite nice. Yeah.
I'm not sure what I did was right or wrong because I was quite adamant, you know, that no, you know, the Sakhi can't be that soft. Sakhi has to be strong. Then Priyanka will tell, no, hero has to come back. No, you cannot let him go. If I'm not convinced, I'll be looking like this.
Yeah. Real drama queen there.
Everything is seen on my face.
You can read it like a book, yes, your face.
Yes.
Just express less, you know, because what you feel, I know what you're thinking, you know, because everything is there for us now. So.
No, every time you explode, you understand the characters more. Then, you know, you get into the skin of the character and think, if I was the, you know, the Sakhi or the hero, what would I do? If I have spots, if the mother sees, are you, what would I do? How would I cover?
Yeah.
I think that goes with everybody, you know, as we keep on doing the same thing over and over again.
It changes, yeah.
With her poem, one thing is sure, certain, Divya is a very reliable friend. We can rely on for anything. So that she has...
She's the headmistress also, remember.
Yeah.
Very experienced Sakhi now. Though I know Divya for a very long time, but this has even brought us even closer. Yeah.
I don't remember if it is Ongumalai calling or for Parimala. One of them, they shouted, my mother-in-law came asking, did Nivedita call?
Probably Annai, Annai. Monali calling Annai, Annai.
It's so cute, actually.
No, Deepaka would be saying, Illi re, Illi re, Annai, Annai.
Very nice.
Oh, wonderful. Thanks, Deepa, for sharing this.
Bye. Thank you.